politics is big enough to give everything you want and is strong enough to take everything you have. Hello, namaste and assalamu alaikum. This is Aarti Bish speaking on the topic postmodern politics. Collectively speaking, Indian politics is a complex mixture of caste, creed, religion and ethnicity, which are being tangled with each other in several levels and layers, and often seems to be manipulated time and again to gain popular support and power ultimately. We shout over the rooftop that we are the world's largest democracy and also assume it to be the best. But the reality is, rarely any politician enters the politics to work for people's comfort, but with the intention of greed and corruption. We are currently into 17th Lok Sabha election since independence, and the worst part is, not a single politician is working on the core issues of the lobbying. Not a single political party is talking about the major issues like population, pollution, crisis of water resources, lack of skilled labours, domestic violence, regional stability, and above all, illiteracy. This thing in our heart that today political culture has touched a new low and powerful politics. In India, we don't choose a good candidate, we choose a least bad one. And what we expect from a political representative is to be the most well-behaved of all authority figures, but when we see them indulging in illegitimate behavior, disrespectful talks, greedy debates, never-ending arguments, and criticizing the work of other political parties rather than talking about their own agenda and more. It really makes us wonder whether they are qualified and literate enough to serve the nation. As it said, with great power comes great responsibility. If you look at the facts on ground, then we must realize that 2/3 of people in our country still lives in poverty. More than 800 million people in our country are still considered as to be poor. Rather than focusing on these vital issues, our politics just revolves and stuck with how to grab power. Under this atmosphere, the innocent people, before they vote, are offered a vest of half-truth, equivocal dreams, and also a whole plate of platitudes and rationalization. One more thing that is collectively wrong in our politics that's still clinging on to the past. Now is the time in moving forward in building India a better place, which should not only have essence of past, but the vision of future. Political parties, despite their track record of corruption and skill jaggery, manage to deviate into an authenticity with broad-root response and with a suitable agenda, able to extract the best of the particular vision. We must now think for the close seniority of dialectic and dissection that makes claptrap of not only the electoral code of ethics, but also the spirit of our constitution. Thank you very much.